basically the plan with this valve is we're going to take it apart, inspect it, find out what's wrong with it. Then we have another partial valve that we're going to use to take parts off to make this one complete. We'll reseal all the intersections, we'll check all the spools, we'll energize all the coils to make sure that they operate correctly. And once that's done, we'll put it up on the valve bench, pressurize it, make sure it's all good, no leaks, and send it back to the customer. But then when you energize the coils, they will actually shift on their own. Yeah, so they can be operated from right beside the valve or remotely up in a cab or something if it's on a machine, right? Then you pull them off section by section. You go through each intersection, check the O-rings in between, and then once you have a section out, put it in the vise, take your end cap off, check out the centering springs, check out the spool. On this one, the whole tie rod's coming out through the back end. If there's any damaged threads, like on the end here, just from getting knocked around, over here. Hopefully this one stays in so the assembly doesn't just fall apart, but we'll see. There we go, we're good on this one. And the one generation only has three rods. This is the second gen, so it has four. So yeah, basically these are our intersections. You have recessed areas in each work section where our O-rings sit in. And this is where we're looking for any blowouts. And all of these will be replaced all the way through when we rebuild them. Basically, if you look at the O-rings, they're still intact, but they've been squished, and they're very hard, which means they're prone to a blowout. It's not the greatest condition, I'll say that. There's so many different oils that different machinery, different factories can use. You don't always know if it's supposed to be like that, right? But this looks like it's just AW32, which is what we run here, like a mineral oil. And yeah, that's filthy. So like in the first section, there's not really much to look at. This is just a bunch of passageways and options for where they can lead back to tank or put pressure in, etc. These valves also have a load sensing option. It's just for different ways that the valve can operate, right? So it all depends on how the customer wants it set up, is how you set it up internally. Inside the work sections, if you want to get into this. So that's your spool. This is controls which way the oil flows through the work ports. And when we take these apart, we're looking for any scoring or scratching or any worn out areas. If you look very closely, you can see areas like here and here. Those are the most worn on this spool, but this is in actually really good shape, so it'll be fine to reuse. When they start looking a bit worse, we take our measurement tools and we check the actual thickness of them, and if we have to, we'll check the inside diameter of the bore as well. Yeah, and the center, it's got back here, these are called your centering springs. So when you use that handle, you know how it goes back to the middle? These springs, they bounce against the body of the valve and they reset the spool back to the neutral position. And these ones, they're in really good shape. Sometimes you take them apart and they're all rusty and falling apart. The caps can be falling off. And the only thing that was holding them on was the end cap. But this one's in really good shape. So. Well, that's the inside of the coils, right? As it's energized, it'll allow the oil to flow and then stop it once the signal is lost. Same as if we were just operating it with the handle. On the end of these, they've got this little cap that's a dampening cap, and that's just so when it shifts, it doesn't hit very hard with the flow of oil, right? It kind of restricts it down, makes it operate a little bit softer, as opposed to just being bang bang. So the seals are what, right in here, these are the intersection seals. So you pop those all out. They've been in there so long, some of them get a little stuck. And valves see a lot of heat. When you restrict oil, it causes friction. And the oil going against the passageways, that actually does create friction and causes heat. And after years of use, heating cycles and whatnot, everything becomes old and brittle and hard. And when it
it's at that point, you need to reseal it because it's going to break.
It's tedious. It's a lot of work to change every O-ring. I counted it out one time, and I think it was something about like 600 O-rings in one of these. A full reseal, I think it takes me the better half of a day on one of these. That's about it for each of these work sections. I mean, I'm going to take them completely apart, change all the O-rings, and it's just, I'm repeating this 9 times. So it can get a little monotonous, but someone's got to do it.